So before we get started, I think it's important to answer a very basic question. What exactly is CSS3? It sounds like a very easy question to answer. You could just say it's the latest CSS specification and the follow-up to the 2.1 specification, except for the fact that it's really not. CHSS, or Cascading HTML Style Sheets. Now, thankfully, the H was removed, making it easier to say and much more representative as a style sheet language that can be used for multiple markup languages, not just HTML. The 1.0 specification was quickly followed up by the CSS 2.0 specification, which was released as a recommendation in 1998. Like any new standard, CSS has had its share of growing pains. CSS 1 and 2 were released at a very volatile time in the development of web browsers. In the late 90s, browser manufacturers were not as interested in ensuring that their browsers were standards compliant. In many cases, browsers would introduce their own proprietary way of dealing with presentation or just offer uneven support for CSS. Now, couple that with the fact that the CSS 2.0 specification continued to be updated, even though it was a published recommendation, and you had a real problem with CSS gaining traction. In fact, to this day, not a single browser fully implements the 2.0 specification. It was this environment that prompted the W3C to start work on revising the 2.0 specification. Now, this revision, dubbed CSS 2.1, was issued as a candidate recommendation in 2004, and it's largely what people are talking about when they discuss CSS. Support for web standards continued to grow during the development of CSS 2.1, and browser manufacturers began to get really serious about implementing the standard. For the most part, modern browsers offer full implementation of the 2.1 standard. Now, you'll notice I said for the most part. Because of uneven implementation, the W3C pulled the 2.1 specification back to working draft status in 2005 to even out the bugs and make the standard a bit stricter. And it was returned to candidate recommendation in 2007, where it remains as of this recording. Okay, so let's try to summarize. The 2.0 specification was released and never fully implemented, and the 2.1 revision was released, pulled back to working draft, and then released again as a candidate recommendation over the course of about 6 years. Now, saner minds might reason that the W3C should get one standard released and implemented before moving on to the next, but that line of thinking ignores the rapid evolution of the web. During the course of the development of CSS, some very important changes have occurred in the way that websites are developed and consumed. The rise of online applications and mobile devices are just two of the changes that the original CSS specifications just weren't designed to address. With that in mind, the W3C the mix. Now, while this is a smart way to make sure the evolution of CSS responds to the web community's needs, it can make it difficult to keep track of all of it. In our next movie, we'll do that by discussing the current state of CSS3 and by showing you how you can keep up with the development of the different modules.